I think there's someone right in front of me.
Thank you.
The top two teams in the Golden Horseshoe Conference take to the ice for the sixth and final time this season. Just before we begin this evening, the Corvairs would like to express their sadness. The loss of Vice President Noah Hill over the past week. The funeral tomorrow morning at 11 a.m. Noah involved with Oswegan Speedway, Brown Auto Service out in Eagle Place, several other area sports teams. Noah will be truly missed. The Noah, one of many of the losses since the Corvairs won the Sutherland Cup back in May. Tyler Norrie, of course, passing over the summer. Todd Ratchford losing his grandmother. And we'll pause for a second and we'll see if the PA announcer makes mention of Noah before we begin.
Those who were here last week, help us in supporting the family and the Thomas family as they battled at the hospital in Hamilton. Tonight, a different kind of support. In memory of Noah Thomas, tomorrow we may bury his earthly remains in the Grand United Church Cemetery, but with your support, his spirit will live on forever in the Caledonia Pro-Fit Corvairs room. Please stand for a moment's silence for Corvair Vice President Noah Thomas. Rest in peace, Nazareth Noah D. Thomas.
So again, the Corvairs playing tonight in memory of Noah Thomas. Apologies off the top of the broadcast, of course. Noah tight with owner Ken Hill, so sorry for the mix up there. Again, the funeral tomorrow morning at 11 o'clock, and you can find further details in yesterday's edition of the Brantford Expositor. As we proceed to tonight, the Corvairs with a convincing 14-1 win over the Pelham Panthers last night. As the 25-11-2 second place Welland Jr. Canadians meet the 35-3-2 first place Caledonia Corvairs. The Canadians win the opening draw down the far side. Purdy with Connor Bramwell streaking to the net. Purdy on the far side on the right wing. Bramwell 2-3. far ahead of him down through center on the offside. Purdy stays on to take the draw from the neutral zone. Fitzgerald from the near side board. Forsman firing wide. Chris Melner, the attempted clear out. It's kept in by Blunt. And the shot wide picked up now by J.C. Travers. Fitzgerald, the tap into the Caledonia zone. Blunt throws it far side. Everyone back for the Welland Canadians with the Caledonia forward line moving down the far side. Thomas Flack checked by Purdy. And the second whistle, 48 seconds into period number one. The Corvairs lighting up the net last night with a 14-1 victory on the road. Caledonia with the first three goals of the game. Peacock, Gomes, and Bramwell all scoring for Caledonia. Riley Quesnel with the only response for Pelham at the 18:41 mark on the power play. That in the first period. Ratchford to the backhand. The centering pass, Chris Jansen caught out of position on the far side, but Ratchford unable to find an open Caledonia forward on the left wing. Peacock shakes off the check of Josh Allen. Allen able to get back, whip it off the boards around the near side, and Matt Martin picks it up for Welland. Ruggi to the far side. Welland on a bit of a mini skid as of late, a two-game losing streak, upset by the Fort Erie Meteors at home last Sunday. And the Corvairs clear down the ice, and Jansen looks on as it goes for icing off to his right-hand side. Caledonia proceeding to score 11 straight goals to end the game last night. 6 in the second, 5 in the third. So the game not really in doubt after the first period. Dakota Miskolczy scoring the game-winning goal for the Fort Erie Meteors in that 2-1 win last Sunday. Here's Gomes, whips a shot, the rebound, and they score! Gomes down the left wing, shot from the circle, got the rebound as well, and then Jansen out of position, Jake Brown putting it in the empty net, the tap in from the far side, 2 minutes and 2 seconds into the first period of play, and the Caledonia Corvairs strike quickly, and they lead 1-0 on the Jake Brown goal. Enma out to play it. He whips it around the near side. Travers moves off the right side of the defense to play it. De Laurentiis trying to clear. The shot by Travers wide. Horst sends his man flying. And Chris Melna down in a heap on the far side. Or Matt Cuglietta, excuse me. Had his face covered up on the fall down at the far side, the Matt Hoare hit. And difficult to see his jersey number from that far side. Hoare now doing some pushing and shoving with Christian DeFonso. Caledonia 5-1 on the, or excuse me, 4-1 on the season series against the junior Canadians. Welland, their only win coming back the first game of the season, September the 13th here at the HCCC. The 3-0 Welland shutout. Fontana the wraparound. Jansen getting just a piece of it to knock it wide on the far side. Melna tried to clear, stood up by Blunt, and it's picked up by a now fallen Josh Allen on the body check by Luke Sinclair. Patton around the net for Fontana. Delayed call coming up here. Fontana spins around for a shot from beside the left circle. And Luke Sinclair slides to the ice trying to grab the rebound. A stoppage in play with 16:28 remaining in the first. Caledonia with the 1-0 lead on the Jake Brown goal. And now they'll go to their first power play. Lepore right side, yanks it off the wall. De Laurentiis leaves it. And it's chopped up the near side by Connor Roskovich. Four top of the blue line to Blunt, far side, back to Blunt, the shot, Peacock there, and De Laurentiis as well on the far side. Peacock let it go, De Laurentiis with a shot inside the high right circle. Caledonia with two shots to start the power play. Peacock around the net, a hard body check in the near corner by Christian DeFonso. And as a result, it sends the disc the length of the ice on the far side. 1:11 to go and the first penalty of the game to Gabe Ruggi of Welland. Under the end line, Peacock. Halfway through the power play as Hoare picks it up on the far wall. Plays it to the end line to Peacock at the circle. Peacock with a one bounce pass to the far corner. De Laurentiis turns around and a nice dive for the clear out by Cam Aiken. Trying to find Riley Van Horn on the initial pass at the left, and now he's regrouping inside his own line up to the right side to Hoare, back to Van Horn, and he clears it in on the far corner. Van Horn to the far side now. Gomes the pass across to Jake Brown. Brown spun around by Allen to the half wall. Tanev throws it back to the left side for Ratchford. The shot, Gomes tried a deflection. But I think the initial shot by Ratchford was the one that went through side of the net, and they score! Gomes side of the net off the cross-ice feed from Jake Brown. Gomes taps it in on the empty side on the far side. Gomes on the backdoor play. And Brown and Gomes now each with a goal and an assist with 14:27 remaining. Tanev to Moran, back through center. Allen plays it back to Nathan McDuff, the other Welland defender. Tanev catching a piece of the 5:33, the time of the Caledonia second goal. So on the pass across by Brown on the near corner, Tanev with just a little touch before Gomes tapped it in at the far side. McEnany to center. McEnany, one of the representatives for the Corvairs at the All-Star game on Monday night, 7:30 at the Fort Erie Leisureplex. Caledonia representing Team White along with members of the St. Catharines Falcons, Fort Erie Meteors, and Pelham Panthers. All remaining squads on Team Black for the Monday night game. Sinclair to the right-hand side, throws it in behind the net. Fontana picks it up, spins around, and he loses it at the top of the blue line to Mitch Reed, but Reed unable to clear the line. Jansen throws it around the boards and the length of the ice. Blunt goes back to get it. 12:42 remaining, first period of play. Gabe Paul on the forecheck, the clear ahead. bounces off his left skate. Paul unable to do anything with it. So Sinclair plays it back to Forsland. Forsland smashes it off the wall and down the near side where Jansen plays it to his defender, Allen. Rougi, Sinclair on him on the second chance, plays it across to Allen. And the Corvairs try to swat it to the attack zone from the near corner. Peacock far half wall, able to clear back to the neutral zone. Gomes slaps it past Aiken, grabs his own pass, centering pass, looking for Peacock, and a slash coming up. We'll take a break quickly before the second Caledonia power play of the game. You're watching Corvairs Hockey on YouTube. De Laurentiis in the draw, wins it cleanly back to Blunt, up the near side for Hoare. Blunt far side to Lepore. Not sure or not if that second Caledonia goal was a power play marker. Don't seem to recall that it was. Entma out to play it, 1:33 remaining in the Josh Allen penalty. The shot by De Laurentiis, he heads to the net. De Laurentiis with a shot in between the pads of Jansen. Went after his own rebound, but Jansen able to make the save on the second shot as well. Jansen with a 17-9-1 record, a 207 goals against average on the year. Face off, Tanev kicks it ahead. Travers backhands it up to the line, but not out. Van Horn to the far corner. Under the end line goes Tanev. Tanev with Rougi chasing him, plays it to Ratchford. Tanev over top the circle, back for Ratchford, fakes a shot. Tanev and Ratchford going back and forth now before it's picked up and cleared by J.C. Travers. Pass ahead to Bramwell. Bramwell to the right wing for a streaking Tanev. Tanev picks up speed, rounding the near corner now. Brown the shot. Bramwell at the doorstep. Bramwell and Lepore right in front of Jansen. Jansen by far the busier of the two netminders. Mark Sinclair in the net for Caledonia last night. Entma in tonight. Chipped off the far wall. De Laurentiis back to the right. Van Horn plays it up the side wall for Lepore. It's broken up and cleared by the junior Canadians as we just about hit the halfway point. 2-0 Corvairs. Jake Brown and Nathan Gomes exchanging first and second goals. Both of those players with either a goal or an assist on the first two Caledonia goals. So Brown and Gomes 1-1 now. Tanev drawing the first assist at the 5:33 mark on the second Caledonia goal. Welland losing last Saturday as well to the Ancaster Avalanche with 20 seconds left in overtime. Shot by De Laurentiis. Hoare picks it up under the end line. McEnany winds up. And with De Laurentiis parked on the doorstep out the far side, Jansen able to hang on to that one as well. Welland now back to full strength. Luke Sinclair in the draw. Allen out of the box, throws it around the near board. Aiken up to the neutral zone, body checked by McEnany, and Entma comes out of his net to play the disc down the near wall. unable to clear the half wall. Paul slides underneath McEnany, the centering pass, and Fontana takes it away, plays it up to Patton. Patton, the inbound feed for Fontana, the shot, they score! Luke Sinclair gathering in the rebound off the far end board and smashing a shot along the ice over top the right circle. Luke Sinclair with the third Caledonia goal. 9:09 remaining in the first. So at the 10:51 mark, Caledonia with goals at 2:02, 5:33, and now 10:51.
For number 9, Luke Sinclair. Assisted by number 16, Connor Patton, and 77, Oslo Fontana. Goal 10 minutes, 51 seconds.
Patton and Fontana drawing the assist.
For by 9, Luke Sinclair, from 16, Patton, and 77, Fontana.
Purdy to the left-hand side for Bramwell. Bramwell tries to make a pass to the near side of the net for Tanev on the backhand. Bramwell shakes off the check of Christian DeFonso. Now he's sandwiched in between two Welland players. DeFonso and Cole McKnight manage to get it to Purdy anyway for the low shot. Brandon McCorriston now coming in for the Welland Jr. Canadians. So Jansen replaced for the night. Perhaps a good thing for him as he gets ready for the All-Star game on Monday night. So a bit of a rest for him. I'm sure he's not happy with the three goals. Although Welland in action tomorrow night at the Welland Arena, a 7 o'clock game against the Thorold Blackhawks. As everyone ducking on the Caledonia bench, the puck sailing out of play, a direct across the ice pass, and Lepore and Tanev with the big duck to avoid the disc at the Caledonia bench. McDuff past the end line. Peacock now in there. McDuff goes down to one knee. Peacock able to slide it across. Gets it back on the short return feed from Jake Brown. Ratchford off the sidewall. Brown to the net. The backhander. Peacock unable to bat it out of the air. A good pass by Brown close into the net on the two-on-one, but Peacock unable to get a stick on it. Peacock now in the near corner. Side of the net, the shot by Gomes. Gomes looking for his second. Brown under the end line. Shot by Peacock and he scores! Jordan Peacock, the fourth Caledonia goal with 6:41 remaining. And the Corvairs are kind of making this look like a rout even early on. Welland was still plenty of time, and I'm sure being the second place team in the conference, they'll have some coaching strategy by Keith Osborne, their coach. He'll give them a good yelling out through the first intermission, try and wake his team up.
Corvairs' fourth goal, 4-7 Peacock, from 88 Brown and 23 Gomez.
So Brown and Gomes collect some R points on the Peacock fourth goal. Those two players now with 3 points each. Peacock with a fourth Caledonia goal. Peacock with 3 goals and 2 assists in last night's 14-1 win over the Pelham Panthers. Brown with a goal and 3 assists last night. Played up the wall, Lepore pass center looking for Hoare. DeFonso tries to swing the front of his stick to get the pass away from Hoare. Paul checked at the far side wall by Forsland, and a whistle with 5:31 remaining first period of play. So the Caledonia squad, or the Caledonia portion of Team White for the All-Star game, rather. Once again, a reminder, a 7:30 game at the Fort Erie Leisureplex. Arc Pro will be there, so we'll see you either there or online on YouTube. Team White consisting of Caledonia, St. Catharines, Fort Erie, and Pelham. And Team Black consisting of the other four teams in the division play on the near side wall. Blunt winds up, fires a shot wide in behind the net. McDuff alongside Patton. Patton gives to Fontana the long cross ice feed, and it's picked off by Paul. Paul and Cuglietta then go off on a change on the clear in down the far side. Fontana from the half wall. Allen with Patton on him, throws it to the other side, and the Canadians able to clear the zone as a result. Matt Martin, a chop on the stick of Todd Ratchford. No call there, must have got all stick. Ratchford's stick staying intact, so no penalty on the play as Purdy clears it in off the board. McCorriston, the short backhander. Play down the far side Caledonia zone. Entma out to play it. Cross ice feed. Purdy trying to move around Ruggi. Fitzgerald hit hard on the back. Ratchford with a hard hit. And perhaps a call here on the Ratchford hit. The whistle going immediately with 3:41 remaining. Nope, just a face-off in the neutral zone. Must have been an offside. Ratchford with the hard hit on the back on the far side. No call, just an icing. And it's tipped in by Melna. Ratchford back. And he takes it away and swings the disc around the near side board. Cipriano centers for Melna. And a great defensive play by Riley Van Horn. Van Horn, one of the December player of the month for the Corvairs. The shoot in, and Melna tries to tip it in between the legs of Entma, and Entma remaining sharp despite the fact that he hasn't seen much action in this first period. The bulk of the play down in the Welland zone. McEnany gathering it in, slides it up the far board for Peacock. The shot by Peacock along the ice, and McCorriston hangs on the far side. Peacock looking for a second. This game brought to you by real estate sales representative Roland Archer of Remax Land Exchange. If you're in the market to buy or sell a property, as Gomes clears it around the far side board and in behind the Welland net. Gomes past the end line for Peacock. Back to Gomes. give Roland a call at 519-755-7409 or email him at roland@rolandarcher.ca. You can visit him online at remaxlandexchange.ca. Paul, top of the blue line, has it taken away by Jake Brown. Gomes out to his left. The shot by Gomes, and the Gomes shot hit the near side of the Welland net. Peacock far side. Gomes with some room. Rougie looking on. The backhand pass to the far side of the net. Gomes with a goal and two assists in this first period, along with Jake Brown. Peacock and Sinclair with the other goals as it's shot wide by Forsland. Peacock gathers it in. Slid along the near board for an open Forsland. De Laurentiis, the shot by Blunt. De Laurentiis came in on a fast change, the only Corvair to change with under a minute and a half to go. The other four stayed on as the shot sailed wide of the far, or wide to the far corner, excuse me. Poor by himself down the left side. A heavy hit by Josh Allen. Poor shakes off the check, well unable to leave the zone as a result of the check on Hoare, shot by Cam Aiken. Wide to the near side, only under a minute to go now. Van Horn tried to get his right skate onside, was unsuccessful. 37.7 seconds remaining in the first. Caledonia representatives in the All-Star Game: Jordan Peacock, Connor Bramwell, Connor Patton, Todd Ratchford, Austin McEnany, and Kevin Entma. Entma second in the league in goaltending. So six players representing the Corvairs at the All-Star Game on Monday. Six as well for the St. Catharines Falcons: Tyler Morrison, Tyler Jackson, Ryan Doucette, Brian Sircone, Justin Falker, and the goaltender Jonathan Delario. 21 players per squad as the horn goes, so approximately six reps per team. Goals by Jake Brown, Gomes, Sinclair, and Peacock. The Corvairs with the large advantage in play through one period. Chris Jansen being pulled after three goals for the Welland Jr. Canadians. Now in net for Welland, Brandon McCorriston. And at the end of one, on the strength of four Caledonia goals, it's the Caledonia Corvairs 4 and the Welland Jr. Canadians no score.
having fun yet. Richard Vanderhoof. Add to that.
I haven't had. I'm kind of shy away from this.
Yeah, I was just picking a roller. On Monday night, if you want, I'll do the play-by-play. Give you the color. I'll make sure, though, that whoever just wants to interview the two periods is ready to go on that as well.
I had trouble getting a pass every year. Do you have Mods in your office?
We can get
Okay. Because I have one now, but it's kind of a situation. And I can't work on the road, but tomorrow I'm in Welland.
Yeah, so I'll be there.
And they always give me a hassle when I'm on the road. Around here, it's not so bad because everybody knows me. If I go to St. Catharines or Welland, I can't go to work.
We'll give you a...
Okay.
What do you have now, the Caledonia Pass?
I have Brantford's.
Oh, Brantford. Yeah, they'll give you a hard time.
Play-by-play over there kind of went knocked off of it.
Yeah.
Because we're having some camera problems with the memory card. I'm going to have to brush up on the
But I guess there's eight guys that need to be interviewed or something. But anyway, I'll be there bright and early on Monday. I'll be in Welland tomorrow night too if you want to have a chat.
Okay.
Looking forward to working with you. It's like 17 days of shooting for a trades program. So whatever days you're not going to see, if you want to get some extra money, let me know.
Yeah.
6 a.m. So after that, you'd know.
Yeah.
Of that, so you have to go in that day?
Yeah. They tried their best to call the night before, but
they have no choice. Okay. Now, if I were to book you for shoots, are you like what do I, is turning down shifts, is it bad for you? Like,
does it
push you down the list? Okay, because I wouldn't mind pre-booking you, but I don't want to like lose my shooter. But if it's steady, then maybe I'll look for alternates, though.
When is it?
It starts February 2nd and it runs till March 17th. And it's like 3 1-week, 2 shoots the next week. It might fit in well, depending on what days you're getting shifts.
So I'll send you the schedule anyways, review it, and then we'll go from there. Yeah, yeah. John, so you're all good? You're okay taking the kick to Welland tomorrow? Did you get Dudley and get you the
What are we doing for Monday?
Monday? Monday's already there.
Tomorrow night?
And the other one's coming Sunday night.
Is the All-Star game in Fort Erie?
Plattsville, so he's staying with one of his friends.
So you're not going at all then? Okay, we're driving to Fort Erie, so we're going to have to do that. Richard said he was going to do play-by-play, so I'm going to have to brush up on the interview. So Dave, send me a rough outline on what you want. I gotta do some stats for tonight anyway, because it's all zeros. I don't have any stats. That's all I can find. So I just stay with Richard, and the players will come up automatically.
Nope, the players will do the
This year we're playing for the Rochester Institute of Technology.
I'll send you an email before the game.
And these are running for the Hoping Nature Award as a national award. And they are open to online voting. We could get one of our Corvair family as the Hobie Baker Award. Go to hobiebaker.com and vote for Matt Karkowski. Golden Eagle from the past, an organization to the Corvairs.
Caledonia with the large shots on goal advantage through one period, 16-4. That result reflecting on the scoreboard as well. Caledonia with the 4-0 advantage after one period. Purdy to take the opening drive with Tanev out to his right. Max Cipriano opposite the Caledonia center iceman. Cipriano wins it, thrown around the far side board. Puck comes free. Melna takes his man out at the near corner, takes Purdy out, and now the Corvairs try to move it out of their zone, or move it from the far wall back to the point as Cipriano dumps it in for Welland. Six representatives for Team Black from the Welland Jr. Canadians. We'll go over that in a second. The shot, the big kick save by McCorriston. Forsland with the shot low to the ice from over top the left circle. 55 seconds into period number two. Drop to Tyler Stranges off the pass from Shaw. Peacock got a bit of his stick on it, and as a result, the disc goes high and out of play out the far corner. Six games in the GOJHL tonight, including this one. You can check out all the scores at www.gojhl.ca. Shot of the far corner. The short pass to Reed. Peacock jams it against the wall. McDuff meets him there, and the disc to a halt as two players from either side make sure that the puck comes to a stop on the near side wall. Cambridge 2-0 over Listowel, 13:24 remaining in the second. St. Catharines and Fort Erie tied at one. Fort Erie really coming on as of late. Played this Corvair team tight last Saturday at the Leisureplex. Just the one goal by Caledonia at the 3:41 mark of the third. Brown tries to move around the defender. Lost a 3-2 decision to St. Catharines last night. Upset Welland last Sunday. And as a result of their improved play as of late, they've surpassed the Thorold Blackhawks and moved into seventh. Moran behind the net. Avoids the check of Matt Kuglietta, cross-ice feed. Peacock inside the circle, the shot. And McCorriston with a save on the near corner at the midsection, just underneath the glove. Blunt to the left side, the shot kicked out by McCorriston, short rebound. Moore picks it up, DeFonso on him, De Laurentiis into the corner. 17:20 remaining second period of play. Four goals in the first by the Corvairs. Flack and Forsland. Forsland able to play it away on the forehand down the far wall. McCorriston coming out, and the shot by Lepore along the ice, and McCorriston with a save. McCorriston with a 6-2-1 loss record on the year, a 1.99 goals against average. Sinclair on the draw, Cipriano plays it to the corner for Nathan McDuff. Roskovich up the far side board. Cipriano falling down, and Cosimo Fontana to the far side to pick up the loose puck. Springs loose, Fontana with a shot. The hard one at the left pad of McCorriston. Fontana picked up the loose puck in his own end. Picked up speed through the neutral zone and fired a hard shot from the left side. Shot by Fontana along the ice. Sinclair at the end line. The shot by Van Horn goes wide. Picked up by Welland back to the neutral zone. Ratchford plays it ahead before Mitch Reed takes it away and skates down the far side on the slight backhand. Shaw to the corner. Short bank pass off the wall for Reed. Back to Shaw. Strange is on the backhand. Ratchford, a man on his back, plays it up the left side, but not out. Shot, the hard shot low to the ice by Purdy. And the left pad saved by McCorriston. The third or fourth shot low on the near side, taken off that left pad of McCorriston in the opening 5 minutes of period number two. So Caledonia with several hard shots to the near corner. Backhand by Cuglietta, gathers it in once again, wraps it around the glass. McEnany plays it around the, from in behind the Caledonia net. Wrapped it all the way back to center. The disc continued for an icing. We're going to take a break. 14:38 remaining in the second. No scoring in period number two so far. 4-0 Corvairs. No, we'll stay here. Sorry about that. McKnight to the near corner. We'll take a break as soon as we can. Purdy to center, Tanev off to the right. And a whistle. Purnell, the linesman, signaling a hook. Or Purnell, the head referee, excuse me. A hook by Tanev. Now we'll take a break before we get the Welland power play in. You're watching Corvair Hockey on YouTube. Welcome back. Fitzgerald wins the draw to Chris Melda in the corner. And Caledonia able to clear down the far side just 10 seconds into their penalty kill. Josh Allen lets it go. Blunt looks on as the play goes for icing. And a slow start so far for the Welland power play. As Fontana will take the draw all the way up the other end from the left circle. Won the draw, but the Canadians picked it up on the left wing. Allen now Ruggie calling for it. Instead, plays it ahead for Fitzgerald. Melma in the corner, the Utica College signee. With Fontana on him, plays it back to Ruggie. Allen from the left, the backhand pass, unable to find Shaw. And Blunt hammers it down the ice with 1:09 remaining on the Caledonia penalty. Six Welland players representing Team Black in the All-Star game Monday night. Braden Storks, Matt Cuglietta, Josh Allen, Gabe Ruggie. Who am I missing here? I guess it's five. And Chris Jansen, the goaltender. Travers through the neutral zone. Tipped in by Cuglietta. Cipriano down past the end line. Reed tried to make a play, but Ratchford hammers it the length of the ice. Still no shot on net for the Canadians as the bulk of their power play spent down in their own end. Team Black for the All-Star game. Welland, Ancaster, Niagara Falls, and Thorold. Centering pass, Cuglietta wires it wide off the inbound feed from Cipriano. The backhander by the Welland defense. Cuglietta shot wide, so the Canadians registering no shot at all on that power play as the Corvairs back to full strength. 12:22 remaining in the period. The concept for the All-Star game, the top two teams in the Golden Horseshoe Conference, that was as of January the 10th, the trade deadline, as McCorriston makes the save. So it's Caledonia, the St. Catharines Falcons, and the two bottom teams, Fort Erie and Pelham, but that was at the time of the roster announcement, and then the four middle teams on the other side. But as mentioned, things have changed slightly in the past 2 weeks. Of course, Fort Erie moving up a spot in the standings, and Welland dropping back to tie St. Catharines, so that having an effect. But the All-Star roster is remaining the same. You can find all of those rosters on the Caledonia website. The Golden Horseshoe Conference and the GOJHL splitting off, so the other two conferences already playing their All-Star game. The shot, and McCorriston directs it to the corner on the hard shot by Hoare. Martin, the shot, going one-on-one with the back defender, McEnany, and a brilliant glove save by Kevin Entma. Rougi to the box now for Welland, so I believe the first Caledonia power play of the period. Faceoff back in the Welland end. Jake Brown, Peacock, and Gomes, the forward line, the power play unit for the Corvairs. Martin picks it up, hammers it the length of the ice. Entma out to play it, and he leaves it for Blunt. Blunt to the left side for Forsland. Martin on him, and he swings a long pass to the far side board for Peacock. Forsland gloves it down with the left hand. Tipped in by Peacock. Travers back to get it. Takes a hard hit on the back by Nathan Gomes. The shot, and the Forsland shot high over top the net and off the glass. The Corvair is calling for an interference call with 1:14 remaining on the original call to Gabe Rougi. But it's Peacock going to the box for Caledonia. So we play 4-on-4 hockey for a minute and 14 before the Canadians go to a 46-second power play. Kuglietta in the corner, Ratchford under the end line, ahead to Purdy. Purdy under the end line, wrap around near side, and the shot by Purdy sails wide out the far corner. Purdy to center with speed, drop to Bramwell. Bramwell looking for the shot, fires it low off the right skate of McCorriston, comes back to Bramwell. Two rebounds on that play. Riley Van Horn with a first chance, Bramwell with a second. 9:27 left in the second, still looking for the period's first goal. Caledonia with a healthy lead through one. Jake Brown, Gomes, Luke Sinclair, and Peacock with the goals. Dumped in the neutral zone is Melna. Melna inside the circle to McDuff. McDuff fires a shot low. And the save by Entma with the glove in tight was Melna to the net. And the Canadians will go to the power play in another 2 seconds. Fitzgerald to the draw. He wins it back to Allen. Out of the box comes Ruggi. He calls for the pass immediately, but it goes in behind his back, and he's met at the far side by Luke Sinclair, and an offside on the play. Ruggi tried to find an open shot coming right out of the penalty box from the right side of the blue line. Spun around by Sinclair at the top of the line and offside as a result. Faceoff coming all the way back to the Welland end. Ruggi now over the left wing. Ruggi to Allen down the sidewall. Allen to Fitzgerald, back to Allen, the shot, and a big save by Entma. Entma's been busier in the second period after just the 4 shots in the first. Ruggi coughs it up, Peacock to Patton. Patton wide open on the pass along the ice. Peacock could have passed or shot. Decided to pass it to the wide open Patton, but Patton unable to collect the disc on the forehand side. Kuglietta, the pass to the right wing, and the shot. Andy Paul, the shot, and Entma with another save. As mentioned, Entma sharp in this second period. Cole McKnight, Jake Brown in the draw, right circle, Caledonia zone, off to Entma's right. McKnight wins the draw with a short jam, but it's picked up by Riley Van Horn around the near side. Entma plays it up and around the board, stopped at the line by Traverge, and an attempted tip by Thomas Flack. Flack with the game-winning goal on the first and only Welland win in the season series against Caledonia. Here's a turnover, the shot. And McCorriston with a save on Gomes. Gomes thought he should have had one. Swinging his stick in frustration. The giveaway, and Gomes with a shot tight to the net. Flack with the game winner back on September the 13th. The 3-0 Welland win. Shot and they score! Inside of the post, off the near side, and Caledonia gets goal number 5. Moran with the goal off the left side of the blue line. Wired a rising shot near side, underneath the bar. 7:14 remaining. The Corvairs get the 5th goal. To the net, Lepore, the spin around, spun around by the Welland defender McDuff. Shot by Lepore, wide of the net. Hoare drawing his first assist of the night after 2 goals and an assist last night. Moran down the far side board. 6:30 to go. De Laurentiis leads it for Moran. Moran with a short breather before coming right back on following the goal around the 7-minute mark. shot in tight on the backhand. De Laurentiis off the left pad of McCorriston. De Laurentiis for Hoare. Hoare took it off the left skate. The inbound feed to the front of his blade. Now he goes to the far corner with Shaw on him. Behind the back pass to Purdy. Cut off in the corner by Connor Roskovich, but unable to get it past the far half wall. Purdy under the end line, centering pass out to Lepore. Off the bottom half of Lepore's blade, and Hoare with the tip on the far corner. McCorriston hanging on to make another save.
We got a couple of door prizes from the Good Evening Sessions. One free Sunday.
Purdy and Cipriano in the left circle draw Welland's on. Purdy plays it to the corner, picked up, backhand shot. And a sprawling Bramwell with Ruggi all over him. And still some pushing and shoving going on behind the play. Melna the shot. Melna the shot to the far corner. Referee signifying a check to the head. Well, had his hand to his head anyway. I believe that's the call. And Forslund now going to the exit, so that indeed the case. Cipriano to the right circle, won the draw, but Caledonia on the far back wall gathered the disc in. Cipriano in between Blunt and Moran. Melna now in there as well. And Blunt with his back against the wall. Cuglietta sending him flying to the board. So now Matt Cuglietta will go to the box and things will even up for a minute and 41 seconds. So Welland goes to the power play on the Forslund ejection. But it doesn't help them much. They spend only 19 seconds on the power play before Matt Cuglietta goes to the box. Under 5 to go. 4 on 4 for another minute 34. DeFonso brings it to center. The pass over the right hand side, bodies flying in behind the Caledonia net. Rochford and Paul, and now Rochford with it, brings it out slightly to the far side, tries a long pass to Fontana, picked off the shot, they score! Cam Aiken on the Welland interception, Gabe Paul took it away on the long Caledonia pass, top of the blue line. Hit Cam Aiken wide open. Aiken on the forehand, making no mistake on the near side. .422 remaining in the period. And the Welland Jr. Canadians get their first goal. 1-1 the goals in this second period. Roskovich around the far side. Gomes hit on the back. Gomes sent to the ice on the hit by Thomas Flack. Shot by Flack, tipped aside by Entma. .422 remaining, so the 16:38 mark, the junior Canadians get their first goal. Welland back in action tomorrow night as a shot by Sinclair off the outside of the blocker of McCorriston, jammed against the wall by Gomes. McEnany inside his own line to Moran. Moran, the long pass through the neutral zone, taken away by Roskovich. Sinclair, the attempt ahead to Gomes, instead gives it to Moran, the shot. And Moran looking for a second. And on the long rebound, McDuff able to take it with speed down the right wing. Tanev to Brown. Brown with a goal and two assists tonight. Tries to center, knocked away by Mitch Reed, and Blunt plays it back in. Reed was able to take the pass away from Kyle Tanev. Brown ahead to Tanev under the end line. Spins around off the hit of Allen. Allen gives him a slight shove, and as a result, the puck able to be played to his forward. Allen creating a slight turnover there. Mitch Reed on the right-hand side receiving the pass. Brown and Cipriano on the draw. Welland zone, back to the left side, shot by Blunt off the bottom of the boards. Peacock gathers it in. Looks in behind the Welland net. Can't find a pass. Eventually he loses it to Gabe Ruggi. Brown the turnaround for Moran. Peacock through the neutral zone. Angled off to the right side. Peacock head up, looks for Blunt down the near sidewall. Pass side of the, from the near side, looking for Tanev in the slot just above the paint. Play now back at the right-hand side of the Welland line. Peacock lets the pass go. Brown the shot. Peacock parked on the doorstep. And Peacock and Allen doing some pushing and shoving. The backhand shot by Peacock in tight to McCorriston. And Allen didn't appreciate it, although a clean shot there by Jordan Peacock. He'll be one of the representatives for Team White Monday night. Again, our Pro HD will see you there. Richard Vanderhaden will be on play-by-play. I'll be there doing color commentary. We'll have some player interviews during the intermissions for you. And a reminder, we'd like to see you all there if possible, but if not, be sure to check us out on YouTube. The 2015 presentation of the GOJHL Golden Horseshoe Conference All-Star Game from the Fort Erie Leisureplex. Nice building, Olympic size ice. Been there many times myself. And gloved down by McCorriston with a minute and 1 second remaining in period number two. Last time these teams played, Caledonia with a 4-1 win in Welland Sunday, January the 4th. Bramwell with the game-winning goal. Paul over the right side. Ford tries to move it ahead, slapped away by DeFonso. Van Horn to Ratchford, the long pass to the left wing for Lepore. Here's a shot by Orr. And the shot sailed wide on the near corner. Hard shot by Hoare streaking down the left wing on the feed left-hand side from Lepore. Hoare unable to hit the net, unfortunately. De Laurentiis into the slot to Van Horn, looking for Lepore on the far side. Melna to the backhand, kicked ahead by Ratchford. Melna sent into the corner. And play comes to a stop with Sinclair the last to touch it with just under a second to go in the period. Two goals in the period. Moran from Hoare and Cam Aiken from Gabe Paul at the 16:38 mark. Caledonia ahead 5-1 on the strength of their four first period goals. Jake Brown with a goal and two assists. They attempted shot off the draw by Welland. Very little time left with just 0.3 seconds remaining at the time of the shot. So Welland will go to the power play to start the third period, looking to cut the Corvair lead back to three. At the end of two periods of play, it's the Caledonia Corvairs 5 and the Welland Jr. Canadians 1.
Next.
for Corvairs manager Matt Garkowski. We will be having the $1 $10,000 shootout just prior to the start of Chuck-a-Pack. We'll have some activity during the second intermission.
So I guess we're driving to Fort Erie. Did you hear me? Thank you.
Now approaching center ice, Corvairs stick boy Nick Ratchford accompanies our shooter tonight, Mr. John McPhee.
Happy birthday, Ms. Brown.
Roland got to the bench first to start this third period, eager to erase their 5-1 deficit. Two goals in the second period. Moran off the left point from Matt Orr, and then Cam Aiken breaking the shutout. Gabe Paul forcing the turnover at the top of the blue line. Aiken, the hard shot. Entma with no chance on the shot over top the right circle. Play now underway, third period, as Ruggi plays it to Fitzgerald. Purdy chasing him. Fitzgerald stopped up in the neutral zone for a second. Plays it to Ruggi. He sends it in. Fitzgerald along the near board now. Back to Allen, far side. Welland staying on the power play. A minute 21 remaining in the penalty to Jamie Forsland. And the shot low by Fitzgerald, kicked out by Entma. 18-7, the shots on goal for Caledonia in the second. Shot by Fitzgerald along the ice. It's off the backboard and out the near side. Shaw, the spin around, blunt top of the blue line, intercepted by Ruggi to the near corner now. Purdy hammers it around, but not out. Kuglietta, the backhander to Allen. Kuglietta gets back in the slot, and they score. Kuglietta calling for the pass, found another Welland forward, Chris Melna, even further down underneath, close to the goal line, and Melna makes no mistake, throwing it in along the ice in between the padding of Entma. 1:19 into the second, the junior Canadians score on the power play. Melna from Kuglietta to cut the Caledonia lead back to three.
Assisted by number 53, Josh Allen. Time of the goal, 1 minute, 19 seconds.
I believe that's going to be changed. Remember, check www.gojhl.ca. You can find all the up-to-the-minute scores and statistics. You'll find that Kuglietta goal under box score. Still think they're going to give Melna the goal. Aiken the shot. Gomes down the left side. Checked by Paul. Travers into the near corner. Picks up the disc. Ahead to Kuglietta, the bouncing pass to the far side, picked up by McEnany. McKnight, the tip ahead. Moran throws it past Travers, and an icing on the play on the clear up by Moran. Kuglietta was in the high slot. There was a man down lower towards the goal line, I believe Chris Melna. I think you'll see him get the goal at 1:19. Shot off the end board, gathered in by Cole McKnight. Martin with McEnany on him. McEnany, a hard backhand clearing pass. Martin tries to shovel it toward the net with Flack on the near side as well. Flack now checking McEnany. McEnany falls down, gets it to the top of the blue line at the end of the Caledonia bench. And a whistle with 17:09 remaining in the third. So six players representing Team White for the Corvairs at the All-Star Game on Monday. Six St. Catharines Falcons highlighting Team Black. Five members of the Welland Jr. Canadians, that being Braden Stortz, Jack Fitzgerald, Matt Kuglietta, Josh Allen, Gabe Ruggi, and Chris Jansen. So I was right the first time when I made that call in the second. In fact, six Welland representatives on the team. Blake Lushcomb of the Avalanche, their leading scorer. He'll be on Team Black. Ruggie the turnaround. Ratchford shouldered off by Mitch Reed. Back inside the line, Lepore now through the neutral zone. And three men back for Welland. So Hoare plays a backhander to Lepore, side of the net, De Laurentiis. And Fitzgerald takes it away and heads quickly up the other side. Cipriano shaking off the check of Hoare. Centering pass for Fitzgerald. Melna lets it go. Fitzgerald as well. The shot from the blue line by DeFonso. And Fitzgerald tries to bring it out the other side on the far wall before the whistle goes. We'll take a break. You're watching Caledonia Corvairs hockey with 15:45 remaining in the third. 5-2 Corvairs on YouTube. You're watching Corvair hockey. Welcome back. Play at the center ice red line. 1 step off the red line. Travers picks it up, fires a shot, and directed to the corner by Entma. Kuglietta tried to gather in a rebound before it's cleared to the Welland blue line by Ryan Blunt. Forsland with Paul on him. The pass ahead, shaking off a check, is the number 23 defender, McDuff. A hard hit in between the hash marks, and now Sinclair and Kuglietta tie up underneath the end line. Welland in a tie with St. Catharines now for second. A full 20 points back of the Corvairs. 4-1 the season series. Caledonia last winning 4-1 Sunday, January the 4th. Caledonia 2, Welland 1 Sunday, December the 7th. Matt Hoare with the game-winning goal. Chris Jansen playing in every game of the season series for the Welland Jr. Canadians. Being pulled for in favor of McCorriston this evening following the first period of play. Centering pass, shot by Martin. The block by Bramwell. McDuff mishandles the puck. Bramwell on a near break. Puck comes free to McKnight. Ahead to Flack. Flack leaves the pass. In behind the end line, Van Hoare out the far side to center. Off the right skate of Luke Sinclair. And played back in by Mitch Reed. Van Hoare around the boards. Ruggie tries to corral a bouncing puck at the left faceoff circle. Ratchford plays it to center. Allen unable to get enough wood on it. Caledonia immediately the other way as a result. Peacock shot going wide on the far side. Ratchford plays it down the far wall. And a hook coming up to Jake Brown. And Welland will go to their second power play of the third period. Their first, the carryover from the call at the end of the second. Welland at 17.4% on the power play coming into tonight. Ruggie top of the line for Allen. Allen far side, Fitzgerald, shot by Allen. And Paul parked in the doorstep along with Melna. The save in the breadbasket by Enma. Fitzgerald in the draw, left circle. Out to Entma's right, and Forsland chops it off the boards. Allen, the long pass down the far side wall for Melna. Fitzgerald back to Allen. Allen, Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald, the shot blocked by Forsland, comes right back to Fitzgerald. Allen and Fitzgerald going back and forth a lot on the outside. Fitzgerald the shot, Shaw in there, he got a shot away on the near corner before it's picked up and cleared by Jamie Forsland. Allen one on one, a sliding Van Horn. Van Horn down to one knee to make the defensive play. Allen tried a centering pass. Back on the outside, Cipriano out to the left, back to Cipriano, top of the point, Mitch Reed, Cipriano, Reed calls for the pass, his shot knocked down in front of the Caledonia net and picked up by Purdy and cleared. 28 seconds remaining on the Welland power play, Jake Brown off for hooking. Pass ahead, picked off by Moran. Cipriano to the near corner for Purdy. Purdy under the end line. McDuff on him. Travers gets in there as well. Purdy sandwiched in between the two men. And Travers able to pick it up and throw a pass down the far wall. McEnany, the backhander, shot by Sinclair. And it's high out of play and into the netting, out to the right-hand side of McCorriston. Caledonia next in action Wednesday night against the Thorold Blackhawks. A 7:07 start. Next home game, the 31st. Wind up by Blunt, shot blocked and goes way into the rafters. 1 week from tonight, 7:30 p.m. Pelham in Caledonia, Saturday, February the 7th. Welland at home tomorrow night against Thorold. Play in the near corner. Shot, a slight deflection off the stick of DeFonso. The shot, Lepore in tight to the net far side. Shoveled a backhander. Almost caught the near corner. Disc went cross ice and into the near corner instead. Shot by Lepore in the general direction of the near side. Welland then playing St. Catharines at home a week from tomorrow against the St. Catharines Falcons. Flack ahead for Ruggi. Entma out to play it. 28 seconds to the midway point of the frame. McKnight back for the Canadiens. De Laurentiis with speed around the back of the net picks off the loose disc. Van Horn up the far side wall. Horn gathers it in at the end line. The pass looking for a De Laurentiis pass. The number 71 defender, Ruggi. Lepore picking it up now. So two chances for the Corvairs there before Welland brings it back to center. Rockford smashing his man into the wall near side at the end of the Welland net. That was Thomas Flack. Have another look at that one on YouTube. A reminder, all our games on YouTube, back two seasons, a couple seasons prior to that, ARC Pro doing Golden Eagles hockey. Van Horn takes it away from Fitzgerald. Travers the shot. Clear to the line, but not out. Melna into the high slot. Fitzgerald the shot, and he scores. The backhand shot by Jack Fitzgerald off the far wall over the right shoulder of Kevin Entma. And the Welland Jr. Canadians all of a sudden making this one a close one. The Jack Fitzgerald goal getting them back to 5-3 with 9:04 remaining. So after finding themselves in a huge hole following the first period of play, Cipriano getting credit for the goal. Melna, the original pass off the far side board. 10:56, the time of the goal. The shot, they score! Connor Patton restoring the three-goal lead following three consecutive Welland goals. Connor Patton with a loose puck inside the right circle. So Patton beginning to widen the Caledonia gap once again. The chorus and out the play. Sinclair with his second point at 11:24. Sinclair with the third Caledonia goal at the 10:51 mark of the first. A hook coming up to the Corvairs Fontana. This game brought to you by real estate sales representative Roland Archer of RE/MAX Land Exchange. As the draw in the Caledonia end, Fontana to the box, the Corvairs to the penalty kill, and Ruggi plays it to Allen on the far wall. Melna keeps it in deep. Ruggi whips it around the board. Forslund, the backhand pass, cut off by Fitzgerald. Tipped out by Purdy. Purdy getting just a piece of it at the line past Allen. Jake Shaw, the shot, it hits the end board and comes out the far side. We'll get back to that RE/MAX ad as soon as we can. Ruggi to the far side. And Fitzgerald looking for his second. Well, no, actually, Max Cipriano credited with that Welland third goal at 9:04. I thought Jack Fitzgerald had it on the backhander. Melna off the far half wall. Fed Fitzgerald on the backhand. Cipriano must have had a slight tip on the way to the net. So then Patton, here's a two-on-one developing. The shot, the pass hopping over the stick of Cuglietta off the pass from Mitch Reed. McDuff the shot, gathered in by Cuglietta. The shot wide of the net and closer to the end line. Reed tried to make a play before the whistle went. 6:49 to go, third period. 46 seconds remaining in the penalty to Cosimo Fontana. If you're in the market to buy or sell a property, give Roland Archer a call. Roland, a representative from RE/MAX Land Exchange at 519-755-7409 as the shot by Travers sails wide, or email him at roland@rolandarcher.ca. Cuglietta shoved in the back. You can visit him online at remaxlandexchange.ca. 20 seconds to go. McDuff leads to... McDuff tries to make one last rush, and it's cleared in. Entma hanging on over top the far side of his crease. Welland's next game tomorrow night against the Thorold Blackhawks. The only other action in the Golden Horseshoe tomorrow till we hit the All-Star game Monday night. The West and Midwest divisions already playing their All-Star game back on December the 27th at the Waterloo Rec Complex. DeFonso inside the blue line, off the board for Flack, in behind his back. De Laurentiis intercepts, Laporte of the net, De Laurentiis stops. The pass to Laporte inside the left circle. Moran winds up, and his shot hits the end board and out the far side. Hoare in past the end line for Laporte. Hoare once again turns around, finds some room off the left side, centering pass, and the slight backhand chip by De Laurentiis sent wide. The turnaround by Laporte hammered off the glass out the near corner and picked up by Matt Martin and cleared the length of the ice. 5:06 remaining. We'll take our final break of the evening with the Corvairs in the 6-3 lead. You're watching Corvair Hockey on YouTube.
Winner of the 50-50, Jack Edson. Congrats.
Sinclair wins the draw. McEnany plays it around the half board. It comes slowly out the far side. DeFonso right back the other way out the near corner this time. McEnany impedes the progress of Thomas Flack. Flack decides to go off on a change. Under five to go, the Welland Jr. Canadians making this one close. Three consecutive goals. 16:38 of the second. The goal by Aiken. And now Entma falling at the far side. A penalty coming up here to Welland. Cuglietta going off to the box frustrated. Melna then cutting the Caledonia lead to 5-2. Cipriano on the deflection off the Jack Fitzgerald backhander. And then Patton inside the right circle, getting the Caledonia lead back to 3. Blunt top of the blue line, shot by Laporte, hung on to and gloved down by the left hand of McCorriston. De Laurentiis to take the draw. Peacock on the left wing. De Laurentiis plays it ahead before Travers bats it away. And Fitzgerald clears it the rest of the way. Entma to Blunt. Blunt, tripping over my words. Lepore on the right side. De Laurentiis hits Peacock in tight to the net. Peacock with a hard shot down low off to the far side. Blunt plays it around the board. Peacock leaves it in behind the end line. De Laurentiis, shot by Lepore, goes off the outside of Travers. Back into the far corner, or centering pass, looking for De Laurentiis. De Laurentiis, backhander, Blunt. Blunt behind the back for Peacock. 35 seconds remaining in the Caledonia power play. The one good shot by Peacock in tight. Here he is once again, the cross ice feed. Peacock shot. Peacock on the near side, and then he spun around. The pass off the right side. Two cross ice passes in a row. Don't see that very often. Kind of ill-advised the length of pass on the power play, but Peacock made it work. He got two shots out of the deal. Tanev letting it go, and McCorriston hanging on at the near side. 2:17 to go. Jake Brown with the first goal at the 2:02 mark. Then goals from Brown and Tanev, 5:33 of the first. Luke Sinclair and Jordan Peacock scoring the other two goals. 4-0 Caledonia at the intermission. Moran scoring off the left point on the assist from Matt Hoare. And then at the time, 5-0 Caledonia. Welland cutting the deficit all the way back to two on goals by Aiken, Chris Melna, and Cipriano. Here comes Welland down the far side. Reed with a shot 10 seconds back at the far corner. Shot going wide. Back the other way. Tanev's side of the net. Brown got a shot in there. Shots on goal widely in favor of Caledonia. 37-11. And then Patton extending the Caledonia lead back to three from Luke Sinclair and McEnany at the 11:24 mark of the third as we approach the last minute. 6-3 Caledonia at the final minute of regulation. Played in by Cipriano. Caledonia's next action Wednesday night in Thorold. Fontana the backhand. A reminder, Arc Pro HD will see you at the All-Star game Monday night at the Fort Erie Leisureplex, 7:30 p.m. I'll be there along with Richard Vanderhayden. Interesting player interviews during the intermissions as well. In past the end line, centering past Patton. Welland in action tomorrow night against the Thorold Blackhawks. Reed to the net, has Fitzgerald with him. Fitzgerald looking for his second point. And tipped aside by McCorriston. The buzzer going. And Caledonia with the 6-3 victory here tonight. Their 16th home win on the year. Now 36-3-2 for 74 points. The Corvairs extend their division lead to 22 points over the Welland Jr. Canadians. For the Caledonia Corvairs Hockey Club, I'm John Molson. Once again, your final score, the Caledonia Corvairs 6, the Welland Jr. Canadians 3. Caledonia next in action Wednesday against Thorold. We'll see you here Saturday night for the ARC Pro presentation of Caledonia Corvairs hockey against the Niagara Falls Canucks, 7:30 p.m. Our next telecast on ARC Pro HD, the GOJHL Golden Horseshoe Conference All-Star Game, Team White featuring Caledonia and St. Catharines players versus Team Black, Welland and others. Check the Caledonia website for official rosters, and we will see you Monday night either online or hopefully at live at the Fort Erie Leisureplex. Once again, Caledonia 6-3 winners tonight over the Welland Jr. Canadians. We'll see you Monday night for the All-Star Game or for our next Caledonia Corvairs broadcast, our next home broadcast Saturday night against Niagara Falls, 7:30 p.m. Good night from Caledonia.